Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new Tower Heroes video. As you know, the update has been out, and it adds a brand new map, skin rewards, and a brand new character. In this video, we're gonna take a look at the brand new character Maitake, and how she functions, and what her primary role will be inside of the game. Without further ado, let's jump straight into it. Probably the best thing about Maitake is that she can be obtained right from the comfort of the lobby. All you gotta do is head over to the menu, go to the Heroes tab, and there you will find Maitake for 180 coins. All you gotta do is simply buy her. And now you can equip her in your loadouts. Let's see what she is capable of. As for the basic information, you can buy Maitake for 180 coins from the lobby. You can place a maximum of 4. Her placement area is 1.8, meaning the radius in which you can place her near another tower. And she has stun immunity. Coming up at level 1, here is Maitake, and oh my god, she looks so cute. To place her down will cost you 350 mana. Her damage will be 0, but she will have a range of 3.5 and an attack rate of 4 seconds. It is important to note that she will start out with detection. To make up for her zero damage, she has an effect called poison, which will last 8 seconds, dealing 2 damage every second, which is pretty cool. Coming up at level 2, and wow, she still looks super cute. And wow, look at her shaking that vial, absolutely amazing. She also gets an extra vial around her neck, which is pretty cool. To upgrade her to this level will cost you 700 mana. Of course, her damage will still be 0, but with a range of 4.5 and an attack rate of 3.5. Of course, she still keeps detection. Her effect poison got an upgrade, making the duration 12 seconds and the damage 5 per second. Wow, that is amazing. But of course, her second vial didn't came for nothing, as she has another effect called heal. She will heal ally summons for a duration of 8 seconds, in which she heals them for 15 health per second, which is absolutely insane. Wow. On level 3, she started to become a lot more professional by getting all her vials in a backpack and bringing around a much bigger potion. You can get this level by upgrading her for 1600 mana. Her damage will of course still be 0 and her range be 5.5. Her attack range will be 3 and she gets area damage, which will be 2. Of course, she still keeps detection. Her poison effect got upgraded to 18 seconds and dealing 9 damage per second. Wow, that is insane. And of course, her healing effect also got an upgrade, lasting 10 seconds and healing 25 health per second. At level 4, we start the mushrooms to take over. And oh my god, this looks so cool. I love this design. You can upgrade to this level for 3000 mana. She still has 0 damage, but her range will increase to 5.9. Her rate of attack will be 2.5 and her area damage a whopping 5.9. It is important to note that she still keeps detection. Her poison attack got upgraded to a duration of 25 seconds with a damage of 12 damage per second. And if that isn't insane enough, this effect now also has splash. And it isn't the only effect upgraded, because the heal got a massive boost also, lasting 13 seconds, healing for 35 health per second, and also has splash. This is absolutely insane. And oh boy, you thought it couldn't get crazier, because my Taki is completely controlled by the mushrooms at level 5. First of all, I love this. This is the best designed hero in the game. This level right here is amazing. I love her. I love her. You can get to this level by spending 5,000 mana. Her damage will still be 0 and her range will upgrade to 5.9. Her attack rate will be 2.3 and her area damage 5.9. Of course, she still has detection. Getting to the strongest poison attack she will ever have, a duration of 35 and 15 damage per second. And the splash, that's not going away, it is still here. And although she looks very evil and controlled by the mushrooms, she will still heal her friends for a duration of 15 seconds, healing them for 50 health per second. 50 health, that's insane. And it still has splash. What an insanely cool tower. I love her. As for the levels that you can have on your shoulder, of course you can have level 1. And she looks so, so cute on your shoulder, or in my case, on my head. You can also equip level 2 on your shoulder, which is pretty cool, as she is still shaking that vial so extremely. Calm down there, my Taki. And even though she is in the professional poison business, she now also will be sitting on your shoulder on level 3, and boy oh boy, it looks cute. And even level 4, which I was pretty surprised by. When I saw this hero, I thought they will only do level 1 on your shoulder and that's it. But no, they went beyond and beyond, and there is level 4 on your shoulder. And man, it looks cute. And you also know what that means. Yep, the amazing level 5 on your shoulder. I love level 5, I'm so happy to be able to put it on my shoulder. It's super cool. But of course, we got Voka, so Voka will be staying on top of our shoulders. Don't worry guys, don't worry. She won't be taking over. As for the skins I recommend, the first one is called Melon. And oh, oh boy, this looks so, so good on my Taki. I love the fact that the mushrooms stay red. And boy, for some reason, this looks so cool. On the level 5, she has like little gaps out of her body. And you can see the red through it. It is so, so cool. This is an amazing skin for Mitaki. And if you have it, I highly recommend you equipping it. Although it is my own skin, I just gotta include it. Because I love how eyes looks on Mitaki. This is probably the best tower to put eyes on, besides maybe Fracture. I love it, because the UV map of Mitaki is so good, there is no stretching whatsoever. And it shows, it looks so, so good. Of course, you can also wear something more bright and colorful, like Sailor. And Sailor looks absolutely adorable. For some reason, she doesn't look that scary anymore, don't you think? Oh, this one looks so cool. Inverted looks so cool. Normally, she's all black and dark, and now she is so white, angelic. It just almost makes her a completely different character. And I just love the fact how the mushrooms look. This skin is amazing. I am so sad that I don't own it yet, but man, what a cool skin. Amazing. Inverted is epic. And yes, you guys have been spamming me it, and I already know. Blue Mate works on Mitaki. And oh my god! Look at level 5. Level 5 with the demon mode looks probably the best like Rem in the game. I am so sorry, Voka, but Mitaki just wears it better. It just looks so much better. The twitching fits so much. I absolutely love this. This is absolutely insane. It's little Rem. Look at little Rem. Hehe, little Rem. Speaking of shoulder heroes, Voka, could you like? Come on, you know what I mean, Voka. It's really hard for me, Voka. Come on. All in all, I love Maitake. For one, she is really unique. Healing summoners is pretty cool, and her damage is still insanely high. I love it. Her design is amazing, and in my opinion, her basic level 5 design is my absolute favorite design in the entire game. And to top it all off, she can wear the blue maid skin. Amazing! I love that. I highly recommend you to save up the coins and get Maitake as soon as possible, because this is a unit that you wanna have on your team. Anyway guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and wanna see more, please hit that like and subscribe button. And I will see you guys in the next episode. Bye bye! Voka, why weren't you at the campfire for the outro? Come on, we need you. Voka, it was just a funny joke for the video. Come on, Voka. Voka, why are you packing your bags? Voka, no! Voka, wait! Voka, no! Voka!